good morning, good morning. Listen, I'm coming to you briefly because I know I have not seen many of you. A lot of you guys know that I have been the past week mourning the loss of my grandmother. I want to send a very special thank you to you all who have reached out. I thank you for those who have been of a great support, those that have texted me, emailed me, called, left comments. I thank you so much. Those prayers, that encouragement was needed more than you know. It's a tremendous loss that I am still trying to wrap my mind around, still kind of navigate through another new normal. So even to my loved ones, people that came from out of town to services and everything, my family, I'm just very thankful for everyone. And if you have not heard it from me enough times, I want to say again, thank you. All right, so I want to get into some brief talk about this pandemic. I know we can't say it too much, the name of it, because YouTube does some strange stuff when you, they don't really want you saying the word. But I urge you guys to really take this seriously. It is just as the physicians I spoke to when it first hit early February, they said that it was going to hit again around flu season. And it seems like this time it's coming with a vengeance. I myself have never, the first few months of me really working in it, because I work, you guys, I work based out of a skilled nursing setting, nursing home setting. So we're the ones that really took on the bulk of COVID patients, of the shit, I done said it now, of the patients, where the people, the hospitals didn't know what to do with them. They were shipping it into the nursing homes and things like that. And those first 3 months that we got hit at my facility, it was just like balls to the walls, do what you got to do, grin and bear it, and get these people well as best as you can, rehabbing them back as best as you can. I'm a therapist for y'all who don't know. It didn't bother me too much then. My mindset was just like, I gotta help, I gotta do what I gotta do for these people, and I gotta go for it. I was up in my black seed oil, my sea moss I was on daily, two times daily actually, doing everything, whatever I could, to make sure that I was keeping my immune system in top notch for me. I had staff members that were sick. The amount of patients I saw suffering, the amount of patients that I lost, tremendous. It's a lot, and it's way heavy on many of us that are frontline workers. This time around, I am probably more nervous than I was that first go round. For whatever reason, I can't really put my finger on it. But I just know, I'm urging you guys to please use as much responsibility as you can when it comes to maintaining social distance. Wear your mask. I know you don't want to wear them. I know the damn things are hot. I know they're uncomfortable. Believe you me, I wear it over 8 hours a day. I don't go to work trying to be cute no more with my lashes and my this and that. I don't do none of that no more. I go in there with my head wrapped up, because most of the day all of the day, I'm in an N95 mask. I wear goggles now. I'm in a gown, and then of course gloves and stuff when you're in and out of doing patient care. Like, I get it. By the time I'm taking on and off this shit all day long, I'm too exhausted to come home and hardly cook because of the fact that I feel so exhausted, like I'm sweating, and then I'm going into the cold weather from wearing all this shit, and then going out to the cold, you feel sick, you feel bogged down, mentally it's a lot. I'm seeing family members that are just, they don't understand our policies of you not being able to come into the facility to see your loved one. It's a lot, I know it's a lot. I'm tested now this point because we have what's called a positivity rate. In my region that I'm in, our positivity rate is well over 10%. When your positivity rate is over 10%, healthcare officials have to be tested twice weekly. So my nose is getting molested twice a week. Like, I understand the frustration better than many, believe you me, when it comes to all of this. I know how bad you want to be with family. I know how bad you want to kick it and you want to have some normalcy and you want to go out and all of this. But I just ask that people be responsible, because I want us to get normal sooner than later. I'm tired of this. I got a wedding to go to in Puerto Rico in June, and I'm sitting here thinking about the fact that I got to be outside on a beautiful island at a wedding with masks and stuff on. You know, I know there's a lot of questions, unanswered questions when it regards this vaccine. Honest to God, I know many of us in our Black community, because I know it, I know how we get. I know that we are conspiracy theorists. I know how it goes when we like, I ain't taking that. I was one of them said, no, I ain't taking that the first time it go around. I'm not going to take that. I'm going to watch and see some other people that take it and all of that. I get all that, you guys. I do. But after speaking with my physician, after speaking with other physicians, doing my own research, I have looked into it. And quite frankly, at this point, I am going to get it. One, because it's going to be, I'm almost sure when it comes out, it's going to be mandated for healthcare workers, especially in the skilled nursing setting, to have it. And then for two, my thinking is this, y'all. How much of a risk am I really taking by getting a vaccine versus the risk that I'm putting my life in every day? We have a whole COVID unit at my job. We do now have COVID patients again. We were COVID free for about 30 plus days, but now it's hitting again. It's hitting again. I'm risking myself every single day without it. I am risking my life fighting for other people's lives every day without the vaccine. So to me at this point, it is going to be worth the risk for me to go ahead and take it. I am trying to, I want to bridge the gap. I want us to get out of this situation we're in sooner than later, because these are strange and unparalleled times we're living in, and I'm over it. I want to go hang out with my family. I want to kick it with my cousins. I want to start going back to the islands and all of this. And we cannot do it if people are continuing to be irresponsible in their approaches to this. It seems like those who, if it has not hit you personally, you seem to still take it as a joke. Even those who it may have hit you personally, to a family member or something who was able to bounce back just like that, so you still don't think, oh, it's just the flu or something like that. No, this has and is taking people out. Thank God that some are having stronger immune systems to fight it, but our babies and our elderly, those are the most immunocompromised out of everybody. They don't have those strong, mature immune systems. So you got to think about that. You got to think about that when you are wanting to still have a party and wanting to do outings and all of this. Be responsible. Be responsible. Let's get through this. So, I love y'all. I know we're going to be okay. We're going to keep pushing through. We are going to get back to some kind of normalcy sooner than later. But we got to do our parts too. We got to do our parts as citizens too. We got to use our head. Wash them hands. Stop putting your hands in your mouth, your face, and all of that. When you at them gas stations and you pumping your gas and you come back in, sanitize your hands. When you at them grocery stores, sanitize. Just get in the habit of being more responsible about things, to really help protect yourself and others. I'm seeing seeing firsthand what it do, y'all. And I'm tired. I'm tired, honestly. I'm scared for me, shit. I'm tired. So that's my little rant this morning. I again thank you guys so much for the love and support you've shown. Please continue to send love and good vibes my way. I need it. My mama need it. My aunties, my uncles, everybody. We all need it, okay? We still need it. So I thank you very much. I pray you all have an amazing, amazing rest of the day. Do good to others and definitely do good to yourselves. Mwah.